Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaneyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpandi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. Today, this is lecture number 118 on the module conduction heat transfer. The topic for today's discussion is unsteady state heat transfer in infinite slab. We recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous two lectures also we discussed the unsteady state heat transfer. Earlier we discussed the lumped parameter method and semi-infinite solid. So for solving the unsteady state heat transfer problem or transient heat transfer problem, we have some approximation in the lumped parameter method and semi-infinite solid. Now here we are going to solve the infinite slab. So we consider the real time solid and we are going to solve the problem for infinite solid using the chart. So the two charts which are very popular for solving problem, unsteady state problem, are Heisler chart and Grober chart. So the learning outcome for today's lecture, so this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in infinite plate or infinite slab using the Heisler and Grober chart. And this is what the infinite slab. So a slab of length 2L. So x equal to 0 at the center, x equal to L at the right side, x equal to L on the left side. The slab is initially at a particular temperature, initial temperature. Suddenly the slab is immersed in a liquid, so in a liquid bath. So with the temperature of the liquid T infinity and heat transfer coefficient H. So in this situation, so we will be able to, we have to calculate the temperature in the solid, in the slab for any given time, any position, and also the amount of heat transfer during a particular time. So the governing equation for the slab, it is dou square T by dou x square equal to 1 by alpha dou T by dou T. So this is one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer equation. And the initial condition for all values of x, so within the solid, everywhere within the solid, for time T equal to 0 at the beginning, before the heat transfer, so the temperature is Ti, initial temperature. Ti is the initial temperature. And the boundary condition at x equal to 0, for time T is greater than 0, at x equal to 0, that is center. So there is, the temperature is constant, so dou T by dou x equal to 0. So at the center, the boundary condition is dou T by dou x equal to 0. And at x equal to L on the surface, both sides of the surface, so there is convection, so minus k dou T by dou x equal to h into T minus T infinity. So T is the temperature at the surface. So this is the governing equation and this is your initial condition and these are all the boundary conditions. So with these conditions, you have to solve the differential equation and get the solution. So for the one-dimensional unsteady state heat transfer problem, so the analytical solutions are available. You can refer to the standard textbooks for analytical solution. And using the analytical solution, we can find out the heat transfer temperature distribution. But at undergraduate level, we have to solve the problem using the chart. So using the Heisler and the Grober chart. So what is the procedure to solve the problem? First, we have to calculate the Biot number. So, Biot number equal to HL by K. So, L is the half thickness of the slab. So, you consider the thickness of the slab equal to 2L. So, L is the half thickness of the slab. H is the heat transfer coefficient and K is the thermal conductivity of the material. Then, we calculate the dimensionless position X by L. So, X is the position, X is the distance measured from the center of the slab. And L is the total half thickness of the slab. And calculate the Fourier number. Fourier number equal to alpha T by L square. And from the Heisler chart, take the temperature distribution at the center of the slab and calculate the center temperature. So this is the temperature distribution. So TO minus T infinity divided by TA minus T infinity equal to a function of Biot number and the Fourier number. So TO is the temperature at the center. T infinity is the fluid temperature, Ti is the initial temperature, and Biot number and the Fourier number. And this is what the center line temperature graph. So this is Heisler chart. So the Heisler chart is applicable only when the Fourier number is greater than 0.1 and less than 0.60. So this is what the limitation of the Heisler chart. So we can use the chart only when the Fourier number is greater than 0.1 and less than 60. When the Fourier number falls beyond the limit, then we cannot use the Heisler chart for calculating the central line temperature. And Biot number is greater than 0.1, we can use the chart. So 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, up to infinity. You have 100, 20, 10, 5 like that. So Biot number and Fourier number 0.1 to 60. And knowing the Biot number and the Fourier number, you can find out the ratio y-axis To minus T infinity divided by Ti minus T infinity. So from this graph, so the Ti initial temperature and the fluid temperature will be given in the problem. You have to find the central line temperature. Or sometimes you will be given the central line temperature. You have to find out the time required to reach the central line temperature. So there are three parameters. If any two parameters are known, the third parameter we can find out. And to find the temperature at any value of x, again refer to the Heisler chart. Now the chart is temperature time is T infinite plate at any position. Now here T minus T infinity divided by To minus T infinity equal to the function of Biot number and x by n. So T is the temperature at any position x by n. And this is the graph. So look at the graph. X axis Biot number. So 0.1 to 100. And the y axis the temperature ratio and the line for x by L ratio 0.2, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8 and 1. So 1 is the surface. X by L equal to 1 means surface of the plate, outer surface of the plate. So using this graph, you can find out the surface temperature or temperature for any given value of x. And to determine the heat transfer, so we have to calculate initial internal energy of the plate with respect to ambient temperature. So rho is the density, C is the specific heat of the slab material, V is the volume. So QO equal to rho CV into Ti minus T infinity. And this equation is also available in your heat and mass transfer data. And from the Grober chart, you have to take the Q by QO ratio to calculate the heat flow of infinite plate. So look at here. So here the Q by QO in the y-axis and the x-axis is Biot number squared into Fourier number. Now you have to calculate Biot number squared into Fourier number and the line for different values of Biot number. And this equation, this graph is applicable for Biot number even greater than 0.001 up to 50 only. So you have to calculate the Biot number and Biot number squared into Fourier number. You can take the Q by QO. So from the Q by QO, so we can find out the Q value. So Q equal to QO into the ratio, whatever it is, right? Then we take a reflections part. We try to answer few questions in between the slides to reflect our understanding on the topic. What is Heisler chart? So Heisler chart is the graphical representation of temperature distribution with respect to the Biot number and the Fourier number. So using the Heisler chart, we can find out the temperature distribution or the time required to reach the temperature at any particular position. And what is the limitation of the Heisler chart? You think for few seconds and write the answer. The Heisler chart is applicable for the range of Fourier number 0.1 to 0.6. That means the Heisler chart is applicable only when the Fourier number is greater than 0.1 and less than 60. And what is Grober chart? So the Grober chart is the graphical representation of heat transfer with respect to Biot number and the Fourier number. And we take some numerical example to understand the concept. A 60 mm thick large steel plate of thermal conductivity 42.6 watts per meter Kelvin of thermal diffusivity alpha equal to 0.043 meter square per hour initially at 440 degrees Celsius is suddenly exposed on both sides to an ambient with a convective heat transfer coefficient 235 watts per meter square Kelvin, temperature 50 degrees Celsius. Determine the central line temperature and the temperature inside the plate 15 millimeter from the mid plane after 4.3 minutes. And this is what the slab. So from the given data, a 2L thickness of the slab is 60 mm, so 0.06 millimeter. So L equal to 0.03 meter, thermal conductivity K equal to 42.6, alpha equal to 0.043 meter square per hour, which is 1.194 in 10⁻⁵ meter square per second. Initial temperature is 440 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 235 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the fluid temperature is 50 degrees Celsius, and time equal to 4.3 minutes, which is 258 seconds, and the position X equal to 15 millimeter, which is 0.015 meter. And we calculate the Biot number. Biot number equal to HL by K, which is 235 into 0.03 divided by 42.6 equal to 0.16. And we calculate the Fourier number, which is alpha T by L square, which is 1.194 into 10⁻⁵ into 258 divided by 0.03 square equal to 3.4. And we calculate the dimensionless position X by L equal to 0.015 divided by 0.03 equal to 0.5. So these are all the preliminary calculation to use the chart. First to calculate the central line temperature. So our calculated Biot number is 0.16 and Fourier number is 3.4. Now, so Fourier number is 3.4 and Biot number is 0.16. So for 3.4, you draw on vertical line. Stop here at 1.16 and the temperature ratio is 0.66. So TO minus T infinity divided by TA minus T infinity equal to 0.66. So TO is the unknown, T infinity is 50, initial temperature is 440 minus 50 equal to 0.66. So TO equal to 50 plus 0.66 into 390, which is 307.4 degree Celsius. So the temperature at the center of the slab is 307.4 degree Celsius. And to calculate the temperature at the given position, so X by L equal to 0.5 meter and the Biot number is 0.16. Now for the Biot number 0.16 is drawn vertical line and X by L equal to 0.5. So 0.5 line is here. So it will merge somewhere here. So this is 0.98. So Tx minus T infinity divided by To minus T infinity equal to 0.98. So Tx minus 50 divided by 307.4 To from the previous calculation, 307.4 minus 50 equal to 0.98. So Tx equal to 50 plus 0.98 into 257.4 equal to 302.2 degree Celsius. Now answer to the problem, the center line temperature is 307.4 degree Celsius and temperature inside the plate 15 millimeter from the mid plane is 302.2 degree Celsius. So you have the practice of writing the answer at the end of the solution. So we take another example. A slab of aluminium 10 centimeter thick is originally at a temperature of 500 degrees Celsius. It is suddenly immersed in a liquid at 100 degrees Celsius, resulting in a heat transfer coefficient of 1200 watts per meter square Kelvin. Determine the temperature at the center line and the surface at 1 minute after the immersion. So also calculate the total thermal energy removed per unit area of the slab during this period. The properties of aluminium, K equal to 215 watts per meter Kelvin, C specific heat equal to 0.9 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, alpha equal to 8.4 in 10⁻⁵ meter square per second, and density equal to 2700 kilograms per meter cube. So this is from the Anna University question paper. And this is the slab for our problem. And these are all the given data. So the 2L equal to 0.1 meter, so which is L equal to 0.05 meter. So thermal conductivity is 215 watts per meter Kelvin. Specific heat is 900 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Density is 2700 kilograms per meter cube. Thermal diffusivity alpha equal to 8.4 10⁻⁵ meter square per second. Initial temperature is 500 degrees Celsius. heat transfer coefficient is 1200 watts per meter square Kelvin. The fluid temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, time equal to 1 minute, which is 60 seconds, and the area equal to 1 meter square. So the Biot number HL by K equal to 1200 into 0.05 divided by 215, which is 0.28, and Fourier number alpha T by L square equal to 8.4 into 10 power minus 5 into 60 divided by 0.05 square, which is 2. So to calculate the central end temperature, so Biot number is 0.28 and Fourier number is 2, and for 2 you draw a vertical line and it meets the point at 2.8, and you draw an horizontal line. So the temperature ratio TO minus T infinity divided by TI minus T infinity equal to 0.62. So substituting, T infinity is 100, TI is 500. So TO minus 100 divided by 500 minus 100 equal to 0.62. So TO equal to 100 plus 0.62 into 400 equal to 348 degrees Celsius. So the central end temperature is 348 degrees Celsius. And to find the temperature at the surface, so the dimensionless position at the surface x by equal to x by L equal to 1. So Biot number is 0.28 and x by L equal to 1. So for the Biot number, you draw a vertical line. So it meets here at the 0.1. Then you draw the horizontal line. So the temperature ratio is 0.88. So TL minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity equal to 0.88. So TL minus 100 divided by 348 minus 100 equal to 0.88. So TL surface temperature equal to 318.2 degrees Celsius. And to calculate the heat transfer, so we take this ratio, we take this Grober chart. So Biot number is HL by K, and now we calculate the Biot number square into Fourier number, which is 0.28 square into 2 equal to 0.16. So you draw a vertical line for the Biot number square of Fourier number equal to 0.16, and it meets here at the Biot number 0.28. Then you draw the horizontal line. So the Q by QO equal to 0.45. So you take this ratio of 0.45, and so the heat transfer Q equal to 0.45 into QO, which is 0.45 into rho CL into TI minus T infinity for per meter square area. So substituting 0.45 into 2700 into 900 into L equal to 0.05 into 500 minus 100 equal to 21.87 10 power 6 watts per meter square. The answer to the problem, the central end temperature is 348 degrees Celsius, the surface temperature is 318.2 degrees Celsius, the thermal energy removed from the plate is 21.87 10 power 6 watts per meter square area. And these are all the books I referred for preparing the notes. So you can refer to here for additional information. And this is the book what I have published for the subject. You can refer to here for additional problems on the infinite plate. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to the mail ID. So I will sincerely answer to your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.